What should I do, boss? Kill her! Good evening, Barbara.
Hello?
Fox, I'm in trouble. He's gonna kill me. Please hurry.
Taxi! 29th November Street, quickly!
I feel as if like somebody's watching.
close.
Barbara? Barbara!
My goodness, Barbara! I'm late! Please, forgive me! I'd better call the police. I'd better call the police.
What's your emergency?
This is Alfred Fox, a private investigator. I want to report a murder. The address is 29th November Street.
Help is on the way.
I suspect that the person this hand belongs to must have something to do with Barbara's murder. This photo album. We made it together. The first thing that I thought about Barbara was that she was beautiful. But there was something about her that terrified me. It could have been her pride, or perhaps the unease she felt reading those admiration cards. I couldn't understand her fear until I read them as well. I knew what I had to do, and I had to be quick and quiet. The task was done. I made sure the threatening letters would not bother Barbara anymore. She was safe once again. It pleased her that I was so efficient, so much that she perhaps thought I could make a good toy to keep around for a while, and I believed it to be love. Barbara was a diva with the beauty, glamour, and a big, bright smile. But she was human, too. She had weaknesses and flaws like everyone else. Though for a long while, in my eyes, she was nothing short of perfect. In time, I woke up from a daydream and, well, you can say that circumstances tore us apart.
Wake up, Fox. I need to speak with you. Why are you on the crime scene? What's your excuse?
Barbara asked me for help. You can check that if you look at the call log.
Where were you around 3 o'clock tonight?
At home. I slept in my own bed.
What was your relationship with the victim?
We used to date.
Do you suspect someone in particular?
She knew she was in danger, and somebody was here when I came in, but I didn't see him well.
Why should I let you leave? What is your alibi?
In a pool of blood next to her, you had a footprint. You may notice that his footprint is significantly bigger than mine. After all, who knocked me unconscious if Barbara is dead?
Don't be a fool and stay out of this case.
Daily Chronicles, right away.
Good morning, sir. How can I help you?
I'm Private Investigator Fox, a friend of Barbara. I would like to speak with someone about her.
Well, that someone would be me. I was looking for her, too. She didn't come to work today.
Fortunately, Barbara is dead. I found this press accreditation in her apartment, and I decided to come and check her office, if you'd let me.
My goodness. Oh, what a shame. Yeah, I think you're going to need this.
sir. Welcome. Welcome. Please, sit down. I'm going to be your waiter tonight.
I was supposed to meet here with Mortimer. Do you know where he is?
I haven't seen that old weasel in a very long time.
Maybe I can help you. I'm Mortimer's friend, if I may say. He's upstairs taking a rest. But in what room exactly? I'm not going to tell. Unless you bring me some money.
What kind of friend are you?
Sorry, mate. Business is business.
Did I do that?
Easy money. That's what I was looking for.
Thank you.
if you'll drink. Do you have my money? Nice doing business with you. This is his room key.
This picture can't be coincidence. They must have known each other.
You have no idea, Foxy.
Are you?
I'm just a simple guy, cursed with an honest heart.
Don't lie to me.
Okay, I scam people for a living. This is rough time, and he paid well for Mortimer, unlike you.
Okay, continue.
Boy, that girl was furious.
You are lying.
Okay, maybe it was a match. It was too dark, I couldn't see him clearly. Anyway, I don't know why both of you need Mortimer here. His address is 19th April Street. Now let me go.
Get out of my sight.
19th April Street, quickly.
All right, sir.
Stop ringing. And what do you want?
Good afternoon, ma'am. I'm a friend of Mortimer, and I need something from his apartment. Can you let me in, please?
Really? A friend? Let me think. Fine. But first, you must find out the source of that horrible smell. I haven't been able to open my windows for days. Solve that problem for me, and I will let you in.
Yeah.
Thank you, dear. Come in. Thank you. You saved me. I was going insane. This is Mortimer's apartment. I can't give you the key, so I will be back soon. You don't have much time. I'm in a hurry.
that Miss Daisy? I better hurry up. Finally, I have both dictaphone tapes. Just have to fix them.
We meet again, my friend. Let me get this straight. Give me that or Granny's gonna get it.
You're not gonna get away that easily.
We'll see.
Good evening, Fox. I'm sure you'd like to know why you're in jail. Well, Barbara's case is becoming very dangerous. One of the reasons why I arrested you is to spare you the problems.
I think you were a little late, Conrad. Barbara is already dead, and I'm all beaten up.
Take it easy, Fox. Don't make that grumpy face. I haven't finished yet. In the meantime, I've been given the order to drop this case. I have to listen to them, but you don't. Find Barbara's killer and make him pay. And I'll personally cover for you.
Why are you doing this, Conrad?
Because we should live in a world where even the big shots pay their debts. And one more thing. The other reason why I arrested you is because you are the suspect for Mortimer's disappearance, and this time I just can't let you go. You must find a way to escape. And here, we found this on the floor next to you. The attacker must have dropped it. Maybe you can find him there.
What's going on here? I think somebody is trying to get through the floor.
Thank you. I knew it. I missed the turn again. Well, hello there. You're new.
Who are you and what are you doing in my prison cell?
My name is Farrier, and I've been a prisoner here for a long time. But not anymore. I'm in the middle of an escape, but I'm having some troubles at the moment. Unfortunately, my cellmate is, he's dead. And there's nobody who can read the escape map on my back. Can you do it, mate?
Yes, I suppose I can. I need to get out of here too.
Oh, great! And here, you're gonna need this. When I was 12 years old, I was slightly obsessed with palm reading, so my mother called me Apollo. I can't wait to get out and feel the spring in the air. Once, I dreamt that I was riding a magic horse. I used to play poker for a living. As soon as I get out, I will send a love letter to my beloved. I will always be grateful to you for giving me a hand. This is my second year in jail. I just can't take it any longer. Hurry up, mate. I just don't want our luck running out. My grandfather was a big craps gambler and told us a lot of wild stories from his travelling youth. I will go first. I know where I can find the light. Follow me. Oh no! The light is gone! We must find another source of light. We need to hurry.
Slide is going to ruin everything. We have to crawl now. I could use some light before that.
That's it, I suppose. Take care. See you around. Show me your casino pass, please.
I don't have one, but sir, can you please...
No one can get in without a pass.
Hello, sir. Would you like a quick portrait of yourself?
Thank you, but I don't have any time for that. But maybe you can help me. I need to get into that casino, but they won't let me in without the pass. Do you know another way inside?
There's no other way in, but I can still help you. But let's make this interesting. If you solve this riddle and bring me the answer, I'll make the casino pass for you. The riddle is, what has no beginning, no middle, and no end? Bring what I described to me and I'll help you. What has no beginning, no middle, and no end? Well, did you manage?
Yes, I think so. Is that what you wanted?
Yes, donut is the right answer. Here, as I promised. Take this too.
Okay, you may go in.
Good morn, sir. Welcome to a casino. My name is Nolan, and I will be your waiter for tonight. How can I help you?
I would like to play some card games.
There is one free seat at that table. You can sit there if those gentlemen don't mind. And here, you can't play without this.
What do you want?
Can I join you, gentlemen?
Well, Victor is late, maybe, and with what are you going to play?
I'm prepared.
That's not how it works, buddy. Find chips and cards for playing, and then if Victor still isn't here, I will let you play. Take this one for good luck and get lost until I change my mind. Ah, you're back already. Okay, let's see what you can do.
Okay, let's play. But I have only one condition. If I win, I want information about Victor.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. You're not the first guy who's asking around about Victor. Okay, let's play. Thank you.
What can you tell me?
Where do you think you're going? It's only for club members. Buzz off!
Thank you.
What did you tell him, you traitor? Tell me, or I'm gonna kill you.
Oh, thank you, buddy. You saved me. I was planning to trick you, but after this, I will give you the right information. Here, this is Victor's address, and be careful, he is pernicious.
Taxi, 25th September Street.
Somebody threatened him. What's going on here?
Don't worry, Detective. We're on the same page right now. I won't kill you. He wants me dead as well as you.
He? Who is he?
That bastard boss of mine. I was his right hand for so many years. I killed Barbara and many others, and now he threatens me. I made only one mistake, and the boss is not pleased. But he's wrong if he thinks he will get rid of me that easily. I have evidence which can destroy him, and I plan on giving them to you.
No. I must find that evidence before the cops come.
Thank you.
That's my new destination. I'll bet that Victor stashed the evidence in there. Police are almost here. I'd better scram.
Hello. Can I help you?
I need you to get inside Victor's warehouse.
All right. But first, I need you to do something for me. Something went wrong in a boiler room that causes heat problems. Fix that, and I'll give you the key.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. You saved me. Here's the key.
God, who's that? He's unconscious.
I feel so weak. Please, help me. I think I'm going to faint again.
His pressure must be low. He needs something sweet to get back.
Oh, thank you. I feel much better. Now, please, I never asked for your name. What are you doing here?
I'm a friend of Barbara. I'm investigating her murder, and clues that I've found lead me here.
Barbara is dead? Oh my God.
Can you tell me what happened?
I would like to know that too, or not. They are all big shots, if you know what I mean.
Who are they, and what do you think why they wanted her dead?
I really don't know. Barbara hired me to follow her and make some pictures of her and her friends as some kind of backup plan. And I did. I took a couple of pictures of her with them, and that's it. I don't know anything else.
I found a camera film in your apartment, but there were no photos which you just described.
I can help you with that. Let's go to my studio. Welcome to my studio, friend. Let's get to work.
Okay, but I have one more question for you. During my investigation, I found some dictaphone tapes, and they have your signature.
Oh, that. Well, if you want to listen to them, look for a dictaphone. I think I have one in the steamer trunk over there. Now, I'm going in the dark chamber, but first, give me the camera film.
If I discover that my doubts were true, neither your friend Co...
Co? Who can that be?
Done. Here, I hope this will help you.
Conrad? What's going on here?
I don't know, but I hope you will find out.
Trust me, I will. Thank you, Mortimer. I must go now.
Hello there, young man. Would you like to play a quick game? Find me a missing cup for my shell game, and I will let you play for free. The prize will be yours too. Have you succeeded? See this symbol? Watch. I will move these cups and all you have to do is guess under which cup the symbol is. Good work. I bet you can't do it again. Good work. I bet you can't do it again. And we have a winner. Here, this is your prize.
Hello?
Conrad, it's me, Fox. I really need to see you as quickly as possible.
Where are you? What happened?
I can't talk about it over the phone. Meet me at my place. I'll be waiting.
Old hag! How to get in now?
Right on time, I see. Tell me, Fox, what is so urgent? What do you have to show me?
Can you explain this?
Oh, you find out. Well, this will explain everything. The story starts one night when I lost everything playing poker. Yes, I used to be a gambler, a hardcore gambler. That night her boyfriend won and he planned to take my house, my car, and all the money I had. Then she saved me. She convinced him to forgive my debt. We stayed up late that night, and tomorrow night, and the night after that. However, being jealous by nature, her boyfriend sent Victor to spy on her. Apparently, she wasn't a one-man woman. In cold blood, he ordered Barbara's murder, without a flinch. That same night when we found her body, he sent me her diary with a note. Now it's only a memory. I tried to do something, but Domesticus has a well-protected back.
Domesticus?
My nightmare finally has a name.
His name is Domesticus Sus. He's the owner of the bank, Domestic Financial Group. You have to find him and make him pay. Here, take this. It belonged to his bodyguard. Use it wisely, and the guilt will not fall on you.
It's time for a...
Gone.
guards again.
I need to be careful.
Good evening.
Yeah.
I hope this will work. Wire didn't hold.
What a jinx!
Domesticus has a private elevator? What snobbery. Guess the storm did something with the electricity. I hope this will work.
Come in, come in! Believe it or not, I admire you. I can see all those losers ain't been able to stop you from getting here. So I have a proposition for you. Come work for me. I surely need a guy as capable as you are.
I didn't come here looking for a job. In fact, my future looks brighter than yours.
Slow down, friend. That's no way to treat somebody who's offering you a job. Maybe you need a little bit more negotiation. Will 100,000 be enough?
It has nothing to do with money. Neither of these things can bring Barbara back.
Are you really going to pull the trigger because of her? Silly, silly boy. Okay, let's measure our strengths. That's him! He killed him!
Hardly, boy. That man was with me in his apartment when all this happened, so he has an alibi.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Leave the rest to me, my friend. Take care.